Volkswagen Racing supports South African motorsport. On this edition of Rapid Motion Africa, we're at Zwartkops for the penultimate round of the Pro Tour, the Gold Wagon Challenge and the Altec Porsche Challenge. Big thanks to Gold Wagon for all this action. There's only two more rounds to go. It's going to be really, really close in some of the championships. And remember, the overall championship is still up for grabs, which is why we see a big move. And Calvin van der Linde stepping up into Class A for the first time and looking to take that overall to add to his Class B championship. Calvin van der Linde on pole position ahead of Aldi Monkeys. George Economides is right on their tail, and Adrian Wood, quickest of Class C. These young whippersnappers that come out of nowhere and put it on pole, what happened there?
Yeah, Calvin is a good driver. He's fast. We expected that. You know, at least he didn't annihilate us like he's done to some of the other classes. But it's going to be a tough race. You know, qualifying, racing, two different issues. You have to pump in those consistent laps, and the guy's going to do that best is going to be come out trumped.
The pace is pretty hot in this class, though, and it has been all season. But the overall championship is also a little bit of a worry for today.
Oh, definitely. No, I think we'll manage a second today. And that will give us still the lead, but y'all still have to push on.
Class A and C and a big field of drivers here, 26 of them all in all, heading down towards turn number one, and a good start there from Calvin van der Linde. Joining me in the commentary booth, as always, Graham Nathan. Check the action already, Nate.
Oh, straight into action. Flat out stuff here by Gavin Ross around the outside, on board with Derek Smallberger. Let's go up the inside. Here comes George Economides. He goes past Valdi. Valdi was second on the grid. And is that Eddie Rodriguez going up the inside, the SEW motor car? Let's have a look at Class C start. Great start there, no jump starts. Let's see, down into turn one. One car, two cars, on board, James Early. Wood around the outside. He's going to put pressure on Needham right from the start.
Going into turn two, next con corner. Adrian Wood looking to get up on the inside early on, but James Early's got other plans. So is Keegan Blackensee trying to go wide as he goes right there, looking really dangerous. Putting pressure on to Ramsey. Ramsey had to take evasive action. The two of them come out unscathed, but only just.
Wood has got his sights set on place number one, and so is Early. Let's go back to Class A. Class A, Volley Makers having a look up the inside. Charles Smallberger also defending very, very hard, trying to get to the front. But Calvin van der Linde has got into the premier class and is smacking them.
Yeah, he's certainly showing them way around. You can see him qualifying, outgunning all the big guns and really showing what he's got. Now he's won Class B, which is why he stepped up into Lee's car, and he's into the Class A Golf, and it looks like no problems there whatsoever. Economides is putting a bit of pressure on him, but he'll realize that he's got the race pace and he can get away from these guys whenever he wants to.
On board with Charles Smallberger as we go down into turn one. A light lift and they're back on the throttle. Valdi Mankey's under huge pressure. Hey, Valdi, the next time you see that apex will be the first time, but...
Yeah, getting into that corner a little bit wide. Here comes Hurley all over the back of Adrian Wood. A nice three-way battle here for Class C honors. And remember, Andre Needham is going for overall title too. So he's got to try and take as many victories today as possible. And with this kind of pressure, it's not going to be easy for him. But further back there, fourth place dice on the cards. And Ramsey all over Keegan Blackensee.
This is a big battle for fourth place, but out in front, the first three cars, this is for championship honors, Greg. These guys are trying absolutely everything they know. Sean Needham under huge pressure though from Keegan Blackensee, and they want to get to the front.
Losing a bit of ground there with this little in-house battle, and it looks like a little bit of blocking roll being put on there. Remember, it is for championship, as you say, so fourth place is going to be valuable championship points. Piazza Musso onto the back end of it now, just behind Ramsey, and then comes Governor Sami. So it's kind of a six-way battle there. No one in with a chance of spoiling the day for the guys at the front, unless they can make up that gap.
Have a look at how close the racing is. Barry Groenewald going up the inside of somebody there. Derek Smallberger running a little bit out of position. He's battling a little bit with that motor car, but he is trying as hard as he can. Class A, though, so competitive that probably the first 10 cars are with all within a position to take a podium.
Yeah, it's fantastic to see. And you can see Gossman here under pressure as they go through Gold Wagon Corner. It is the Gold Wagon Challenge that you got your eyes on at the moment. Heading into turn one, BMW Performance, and it is the Ferodo Golf getting away. The Wealth Avenue Polo doesn't seem to have an answer here, and neither do the two polos behind him. Rodriguez has pushed hard. He hasn't caught on, and Mikey's is putting the pressure on, trying to get a little bit more up the road to take on that Golf One.
He's trying as hard as he can because he's going at George Economides for Class A championship honors. And towards the end of the season, it's all about the championship. These guys have been going hard, spending a lot of money, testing really hard to see at the end of the day or at the end of the year who is the better person.
Whoa, what a move there from Henning. Silver Dream Racer sneaking through, and RBTS Golf 2 sneaks ahead. So a good move there from Harold Henning. He's decided, no, you're going a little bit too slow for my liking. I've got to get up there. I've got to catch those polos if I want to be in contention. And I think little Smallburger is going to maybe do a good thing, sticking behind Henning for a while, learn a couple of good lines. He's definitely the rookie in the class. Remember, one of the rookies, because they're the rookies at the front.
Going down into turn one. Wood goes up the inside into turn one. That is an incredible move. Great driving by Needham. They give each other enough room, get through there without taking each other out. That could have been a proper crash. James Early right on the back of that battle again.
Looks like Sean Needham's fallen back slightly. There's Black and C and Lyle Ramsey have got through. And in fact, looks like he's fallen into the clutches. Yes, indeed, of Piazza Musso and Gavin DeSami. And behind them comes Hall. So another four-way battle now for about fourth place on the road for Class C. At the front, big gaps opened up. Calvin van der Lund has pulled away from the three polos, but Valdi still hasn't got past Eddie Rodriguez. So some change has got to happen up here because Valdi's got to get ahead of that man, George Economides.
And George knows that, and he's just doing enough to keep Valdi behind him. He's got the big picture in mind, but I'm sure they all wanted to run with Calvin. Calvin just doing a superb job here, using the traffic to his advantage and getting away.
He's doing a great job. He certainly has. He's pulled about 4.5 seconds now. We're going to be close to 5 by the end of this lap, and there's only 3 laps to go now as they cross the line. So these guys really in the latter part of race number one. Down the back straightaway into Castle Edge Corner. In the background, you can see Henning still hanging on to what is 5th place in Class A. And Henning's got Robertson, Smallburger, and Derek Smallburger's up there too now. So a nice 4-way battle for 5th place.
Oh, some big tyre school. Valdi Mankies has even got his lights on. He means business. I don't know if he thinks that the car's going to go better at the end of the race. Probably set up like that. And Economides has got a buffer. He's got somebody sparring for him at the moment. Let's have a look and see if he can make it to the end.
Well, they come down towards Goldwagen Corner. You can see a couple of guys coming off. Kurt Wesson pulling into the sideline there at the top of the hill. It looks like it was the end of Sean Needham's race too. As we go back on board with Charles Smallburger, he's on the inside of Jody Robertson. Now, Jody, he hasn't been around for a long, long time in polos, and since he's come through, he's really starting to push hard. And that Polo Classic of his has got some pace. So all of a sudden, it looks like Smallburger's in with a little bit of a different feel to the end of a race day than what he's used to.
That's for race position number 5. There's a 3-car battle for second, a 3-car battle for 5th, all over the racetrack. Have a look at Wood. Wood has managed to break Needham at the moment. Needham knows he just has to finish right behind Wood, or really, really close, to do it overall in the championship. But Wood wants the glory. He wants to take the checkered flag, and he is trying as hard as he can.
Well, remember, Adrian Wood, because of a couple of problems earlier on in the season, had to try and make up the ground today. All problems in the back here. Oh, Gavin Ross coming together with Gossman, the two of them in Renexcon Corner. That's turn 2, the hairpin. And unfortunately, looks like the Golf 2 and that Golf 1 have come together there, and they're going to drop back out and probably down into about 12th and 13th place. They're not going to catch him, but second place is still up for grabs. How far back is Valdi? He's still behind Rodriguez.
Valdi is trying everything he knows. Apart from bumping Rodriguez off, Valdi is going to have to settle for fourth, it looks like, unless there's a failure. But going down to the line for the first time in Class A, Calvin van der Linde.
Checkered flag for Calvin van der Linde. Second place goes to George Economides. So he hangs on to the overall in Class A. Adrian Wood is hanging on as well at the front end. Since he got past Andre Needham, he's done everything right. And he pulls in as we see Gossman pulling onto the sideline and into pit lane. Here comes the checkered flag for Class C. Adrian Wood, then Andre Needham. And it looks like James Hurley has hung on to third place in the Coney Golf 1. Brilliant driving from Classes A and C. In confirmation of those results, Calvin van der Linde taking Class A in his first time out. Head of George Economides, Eddie Rodriguez, and Valdi Mankies. Valdi Mankies looking to close down on the Class A lead of George Economides, but fourth place will not do. Adrian Wood, the same thing at the front end of Class C, trying to catch Needham. An absolute masterclass drive there. Well done.
Yeah, we just try to keep it consistent. George was with us in the beginning, and at the end, I think he dropped off a bit. But nevertheless, a good win. Thanks to the team, Ferrota Racing, Racecraft, and Autocrypt. Just thanks. Without them, we wouldn't be here, you know?
It looks like this youngster's got some serious pace. He's had it all season. He's come to play with the Class A boys and showing you the way around.
Well, it's good to see. It's nice to see that there's up-and-coming talent. Second for the day for us was good. We've had 2 bad races at East London and Pekisa, but we're coming there. The car's not easy, but it's getting better and better.
Buddy, a fantastic effort out there, but having a look on the other side of the car, it definitely looks like a bit of rubbing as racing happened out there.
Yeah, well, it came to the start. I had a lot of wheel spin off the line. Andre got ahead of me into the first turn, but we rubbed a little bit, nothing serious. The rest of the race, I just stuck behind him, focused where I could, where I was quicker than him, where I could pass him. Got past him and then just managed the race from there.
Class B, and Calvin van der Linde moving up to Class A. It was blown wide open. Alan Kruse on pole position, Rory Atkinson in second, and the usual contender in third place with Andrew Bates, Steve Hurley, top of Class D.
On the all season long, this car's had ups and downs, and apparently yesterday you found the problem.
Well, we've had more downs than ups this year. We've had also some mechanical issues, but thanks to Jody at JRT Racing, we finally got them sorted out. So yesterday the car was good, running well, handling well, so now it's just the driver that needs to pitch up.
Stevie, a tough day in the saddle for you today. Pole position in Class D is not always the best place to be, especially here.
No, not really. And looking at the times yesterday, unlike the comfort zone we had at Velcom, we don't have that today. I think there's 0.2 in it, and 0.2 between second and third, so I think it's going to be a really good race. Not many places to overtake, it's going to get wild.
On the line now, Class B. Let's have a look. A great start there from Elna. Even a better start from Andrea. A bad, bad start though from Rory. Let's have a look here. Let's see. Andrea goes around the outside of Rory into turn one. She can make it six. She puts herself on the right side of the road for the next turner. So does Eckhart. Craig Eckhart goes up the inside. Rory Atkinson goes from second to fourth in only two corners.
Yeah, and forced wide onto the dirty stuff too, as we see Class D getting underway. A good start from Hurley, a good start from Nathan. That's the battle for Class D honors. Remember, as they go down into turn number one. On the inside though, it is Yannick van Rooyen. He's going to be a thorn in the side of those two polos. You can see in the background, battle's already starting to rage there as Gina Munro gets forced to the outside there by one of the golf ones. All into turn four, and already action. Take a side wall, Elna sideways. Castrol edge corner has caught her out. Cold tires, and whoa! Just behind Andrea Bate. How did she miss the squishy car?
Jeez, that was close. I've even got goosebumps sitting here. That was so close. If Elna had timed that wrong, or if Andrea timed that wrong, it would have been a proper crash.
Eckhart still in second place and gifted second now as he saw the action between our two lady drivers. You see no love lost there. And the third lady driver, Linda Henning, just behind them. There you see, completely wrong. Cold tyres into Castle Edge, one of the fastest corners in South Africa. And there you go on the side. Unfortunately, not hitting the wall, so she was able to get back on. Let's see how far back these guys. Oh, there she comes back on, just ahead of Hurley, Nathan, and van Rooyen.
Nathan getting ahead of van Rooyen there. He was in third place on the grid. Darren Nathan and Steve Hurley are going at it for the championship. This is down to the wire stuff. Big time. Hurley under huge pressure. He's got traffic in front of him. Darren wants past, and so does Elna. She wants to get off to Class B. Now she's getting involved in Class D. Darren, Yanni, Hurley. Look, there's even Jake Jacobs. Jake Jacobs is driving Ryan Foley's car as a one-off, having an absolute blast.
Looks like Elna just getting to grips with that car, making sure everything's still okay. And she slots down into about seventh place in the D battle. So a lot of work for her to do to catch this front back. Not right now. Eckhart's lost out. You can see all of a sudden Rory snuck through into second place, goes hunting down for the car in front. And of course that is now Andrea Bate leading out. We're on board with Eckhart. Behind him is Linda Henning. This little Class B battle between the four cars that are left up the front end is really going to turn out to be pretty much action-packed if these guys can make up the ground between themselves and Bate.
Here's the action though, Greg. Yanni up the inside. Can he make it stick? No. Darren slams the door. Steve Hurley driving as hard as he possibly can. Behind Yanni, we've got Van Fleder. Then we've got Jakes. Then we've got Dion Holiday. On board with Darren as we go down into turn four. This is flat out stuff. He's going to try as hard as he possibly can. Going down to outdoing Steve Hurley. Can he make it stick?
Fourth gear into Castle Edge and keeping it buried through there in the fourth gear. There you can see a move from Gavin Munro sneaking through on Wouter Roos. Wouter being forced wide. So Polo versus Golf 2 coming out of Castle Edge, heading up the hill. Oh, problems for Nathan. Nathan's pulled on the sideline. Oh, Darren Nathan. There goes some valuable championship points as the entire Class D field stream 3 is pulling on the side. What went wrong?
Absolutely out of the race, out of the championship title. I'm sure he's cursing his team a little bit at the moment. But really tough luck there for Darren Nathan. I'm sure he'll be back in the next race to try as hard as he possibly can. But back to the battle. Steve Hurley, a bit of a breather now. Yanni knows he needs to go and win. And so does Van Fleder, and so does Jake Jacobs. Have a look how close the competition is in Class D. It is absolutely incredible.
Remember, both Dion Holiday and Ryan Tholey not really in the mix at the front end here, as you see Jake Jacobs in Tholey's car. So the other championship contenders aren't here, so it's not going to affect Darren too much, as we see a little bit of sideways action there from Batman, just keeping it all together ahead of Jake's. But as I was saying, the championship's still up for grabs, and it depends on where Steve Hurley ends up at the end of the day and how many points he can take away from Darren.
Absolutely. Coming up the inside is Elna. Elna goes up the inside of... Whoa!
Oh, she's
spins it in to Van Vleder. Van Vleder is out of the game. Jake's probably sitting here going, shoo, thank you, I'll have that one. Dabs the brakes, misses all the mayhem. Dion Holiday, wave yellows at the background there. And the guys are on the go again. There they go. There goes Elner. There goes Van Vleder in the background. But we've got Elke Van Vleder, Piet Potgieter. We've got Gina Monroe up the inside of Piet. They go through turn one together.
Not too shabby there.
Wild stuff here.
Awesome stuff. So the Bat Lady out in front of this awesome battle. And Gina Monroe now just gives way. Whoa. And Piet Potgieter hangs onto that inside line. Using a bit of superbike knowledge there. Remember, he doesn't only drive in polos. He's also a ZX10 Cup rider. So he's kind of got this line at SWAT Corps dialed in. At the front end, though, you can see nice little battles. But a nice four-way here between these four, the two ladies and the two gentlemen.
Gina hasn't let go for 1 minute, but Piet slams the door. Going into turn four, he knows, though, that she means business and she's going to come back at him. So Piet has got work to do. Elke Van Vleder, she's leading out this little battle. And Dalton is trying as hard as he possibly can, because I think there might be a bit of a jump start penalty coming. So he needs to get it past as many cars as he possibly can in case he gets this penalty.
Now get that 30 second buffer in if he can, but unfortunately he's being held up by the Batgirl at the moment as they head down towards Goldwagen Corner. There you see, going through Jake Jacobs. A nice little return to form for him, and really good effort from Ryan to give him that car. Hurley's got away. Van Rooyen's in second. Unfortunately, with Darren being out of it, third place battle is where it's at, and right now it's being held by Jake Jacobs.
Jake's is just ahead of Dion Holiday. Brand new motor car. Dion trashed his motor car in Pakisa and has built a nice brand new shiny red car for this race. He probably doesn't want to ding it, but I know Dion, he's prepared to rub and bend panels if he needs to. So Gavin Monroe, watch out, buddy.
I don't think he's going to let Monroe through and give him that opportunity. Vota seems to pull a bit of a gap now as we've lost that battle with Gavin Monroe moving forward. Van Rooyen's out. Oh, Yannick Van Rooyen in the Goldwagen Golf. That is a machine that hardly ever gives any trouble. It's probably because he put the GTI badge on and it's not a GTI.
Yanni Van Rooyen just showing us how quickly they need to get out of a race car. There it is, Yanni. Well done. And unfortunately, out of second position. Jake Jacobsen is gifted second, but out in front of the entire race is Andrea. She's doing a great job in the City Golf. The first time she's led one of these races, I think the pressure is not going to get to her because Rory is a little bit far back. Rory is not going to be able to get there before the end of the race.
I'm going to say hats off to the team as well because they put in a massive effort. As they got one lap to go. That's a rebuild on that car too after a massive crash at Pakisa at the last round. So Steve Hurley leading Class D by a comfortable margin. No one's going to catch him. Jake Jacobs tried hard. Unfortunately, the two protagonists that could run with him both ended up on the sideline. That was Yannick Van Rooyen and Darren Nathan. So Hurley's got this one. He's got one more lap to do it. Let's see if he can keep it all together.
Dion Holiday. And oh, look at this battle. Gavin Monroe, Voto Risk, trading paint and using up the entire racetrack. Dion Holiday sitting there in the red car going, you guys keep yourselves nice and busy. I'll just stay out of the way.
Voto Ruiz wants to maintain that fourth place in this race. He needs to just get as many points in the bag as possible. So as they head down into turn one for the final time, Ruiz under pressure from Gavin Monroe, but Monroe's feeling a bit of pressure too. You see Dalton has now moved up. He's got ahead and he's starting to put that cushion in. Remember, he's going to have a possibility of a 30-second penalty for the jump start.
And he's there. He goes up the inside. Can he make it stick? Dalton goes up the inside of Gavin Monroe. Drag race now to turn four. Mark one versus Mark two. Let's see who can get there first.
It's going to be tight between the two of them, but at the front end, it's Andrea Bate who's pulled away. A comfortable margin of 2.5 seconds. He's going to ease off heading down through Execuline Corner to the final corner, Goldwagen Corner, and a victory going to go to Andrea Bate. Race one, definitely in the bag for her. And I think Rory Atkinson's going to have something to say in race two in the flight hand cleaner polo. He comes through there in second place. And third place, right in the background, but still a little bit way off in the Creation Wealth Golf, is Craig Ecotes. Good drive there from our top three in Class B. Class D honors going to go to Steve Hurley. He comes down to Goldwagen Corner for the final time with a massive margin over his next competitor, because that's going to be Jake Jacobs. And then we're going to see Dion Holiday. So it's the new option polo coming through in first, second, and third there for Class D. Let's see whether or not Nathan can get his car sorted out for race number two. The confirmation of those results, Andrea Bate, Atkinson, and Ecotes your top three. And down in Class D, Hurley, Jacobs, and Dion Holiday in third. Well, that's one way to squish the competition.
Oh, thanks, man. That was quite an exciting race. Turn four there on the first lap was a little bit interesting, with both Alna and I getting it sideways. But after that, it was as we wanted. Get out in front and lead and finish it off.
You haven't been on the podium for a while, but
It's a good feeling to get back up there.
Yeah, well, let me tell you this. I think it's a little bit by default. Luck was playing in my side, but I'll take it anyhow.
You take it anyway. That's
I'll
how
take
it goes.
It anyway, that's the way it goes. Yeah, we ran in a bit of problem. I think our fuel pump is starting to pack up. I lost a lot of power, but hang in there. And as I say, winners never quit, and quitters never win. So we kept on going, and here we are on the podium.
I'm sure looking forward to another one in race two. But now we go to race two of class A and C. And it looks like Calvin van der Linde once again off the line. Perfectly done. But second place is George Economides. Where has Valdi got to? Is he second? Is he third? No, he's got to be three or four, because that is definitely Economides getting into turn number one in second place.
Economides goes defensive just to make sure Valdi right in there behind him. So now he knows what he has to do. He has to end up ahead of George Economides. He's got to do it now while the tires are still fresh. He's got to go as hard as he possibly can. Class C start. Also, once again, Needham versus Wood. Drag race. Hurley up the inside. He tucks him straight behind Needham because Wood is up the inside. Once again, two turn one. They go. So, oh, a touch there. Some great respect by the boys. That could have ended up in a proper crash.
Well, I love the way that they've given enough respect there just to give enough room, and only enough room, to keep all three cars on the racetrack. James Hurley, though, has used it to his advantage and snuck up into second place. Adrian Wood, a bit of work to do now if he wants to get into the chase now for what is going to be Class C's championship, as they head down the back straight into Castrol Edge. It's Black and C in fourth. Behind them comes the gaggle of white Golfs. And I think, by the looks of things, that was Needham. So he's got his car sorted out. No, it's not. It's Ramsey. Ramsey and then Needham. So that's what it's all about in Class C.
Absolutely. But yeah, is a race for the first position. And have a look at Wood. Wood's going to go up the inside. He does it. Wood goes up the inside of Hurley. Runs him slightly wide. Whoa, a little bit of a... I'll go through you now. A bit of payback. Straight away, Hurley comes back, tags it into the side of Wood. They both keep it going. Some great driving talent there. And the race is on again.
Yeah, Blackensy's going to take advantage of this. He's going to try and sneak into Goldwagen corner. Up into second place, he's done it. Perfectly done. He got much better drive. Ramsey's going to try the same thing, and he's going to push. Oh, you know you're doing that. You've just seen what happens. This is what happens. Hurley gets run wide. He tucks in behind Adrian Wood, goes straight for the apex. Early on, Wood takes his normal line and ends up having to get that thing sideways. Second gear, foot flat, and drives it out. Brilliant stuff. He must come from the Nathan Motorsport School of Driving.
No, he drives for Van der Linde. Anyway, let's carry on with the racing and back to the front of Class A. We've still got Calvin van der Linde out in front. Cannot hit him, trying as hard as he possibly can. A little bit further down in the race than we used to, but Valdi Mankies knows what he has to do, and he's taking a little bit too long to do it. Up the inside, though, goes Rodriguez. Can he make it stick? Needham goes around the outside, up at turn five, and he stays in that position.
No, just maintaining that position. I remember with Gerard Henning being so low down, he's got an opportunity of catching up with Wayne Masters here, who's not here this weekend. So Henning's got to do everything he can, and he cannot afford to be sitting down in, what is that, 2, 4, 6, 8, 9th place. Not good enough.
Rodriguez goes again up the inside, but again Needham slams the door, drives around the outside. Eddie Rodriguez probably thinking, what must I do to get past this dude?
This.
Oh, a little bit of push and shove. Actually, a lot of push and shove. James Hurley taking out the other Needham. That's Sean Needham that got taken out the game.
Yeah, looks like there was a bit of argy-bargy again from James Hurley, just getting frustrated, unable to make the moves that he'd like to make. And that's allowing the man at the front, Andre Needham, to pull away. But watch out, because at this point in time, looking at the lap monitor, it's actually Adrian Wood who's doing the fastest lap times. Here we see a move on the inside, has a big look there, and the 95 car just gets spun out. And unfortunately, not a happy camper at all. As you see, just, well, that's not how we want to be doing things, James Hurley. I think the COC might have a chat with him and possibly a yellow card for the final round.
Back to Class A, though. We're on board with Derek Smallberger.
As
that was Needham falling out the game. He's got in behind his teammate, Barry Groenewald, who's riding behind the Wayne Masters car, but that's been driven by Gossman this race weekend.
Yes, indeed. Andy Gossman stepping up and Greg Gossman stepping into his car. So the two Gossman boys doing a bit of duty there, but unfortunately not able to help out Valdi at the front. That's kind of why Valdi brought him along. Jody Robertson is right on their tail. And then we see Rodriguez behind them. It is Charles Smallberger and that little Golf one just learning the trade, doing a really nice job of it as well. Not too far out. And then we've got a great battle. And I say a great battle because right now it's a Polo Classic and two Polos at the front going for it.
But the race between second and about sixth or seventh position, they are all line astern, Greg. Anybody can take that position. This is Gossman with a little bit of damage. This is from race one when he rode into Gavin Ross, down into turn two, getting back in the racing.
I think he's just ahead of Needham, though.
Yeah, Needham's catching him. There's no doubt about it. But as I was saying, check this out. Lyle Ramsey's been caught by Wood and passed. It looks like Wood's going to try something here. Not quite close enough onto Keegan Blackensee, but Blackensee's going to have his eyes on those rearview mirrors, because the green golf, the incredible golf, once passed and once passed badly. And if he can get through, there's a possibility of him catching Needham, because he is lapping much quicker than any car in Class C at the moment.
Absolutely. Touches the curb, runs it right to the outside. He is stretching those tyres to the absolute limit. Puts himself in the right place to take the position. Great driving there by Blackensee. He's going to try and cut back and drag race to turn four. Here it is again. Wood runs it slightly wide. He ends up on the outside, though. He's got the long way to go. Let's have a look-see. Can Blackensee do it? No. Wood manages to outdrive into turn four.
Yeah, awesome bit of driving there. Into Castle Edge corner now. Lyle Ramsey just behind them having a look and saying, well, if one of Yokes makes a mistake, I'm on the podium. And that's all he's going to worry about. He'd like to close down and make it a three-way battle for second place in Class C, but he's a little bit too far back at the moment.
Back to Class A, though. George Economides, the pressure is still there. Jody Robertson right behind Valdi Mankies. He's though followed by Eddie Rodriguez. Eddie has got past Needham now that Needham is out. Put the horns out, and he is chasing after Valdi.
Yeah, he's got to get past Robertson first, though. Robertson goes defensive down the back straight away, but Rodriguez knows the line. He's got to get on the inside. Not quite close enough just yet, but he definitely had a big look into Castrol Edge. Couldn't quite make it stick this time, but he's definitely putting on the pressure. Much better drive out of Castrol. Up towards Sassel corner now. Watch Rodriguez on the brakes.
Let's have a look. See, up the inside. Here comes Rodriguez. But a little bit defensive there by Jody. Whoa! A little bit of intent there by Rodriguez. I'm coming through. Sorry, it's my turn. And Jody Robertson gets forced wide. Great driving there to catch it. He loses only one position and he's back in the game.
Yeah, flight hand cleaner golf on his tail. Then it's the Norbreak man. It's Gavin Ross. So Ross starting to put the pressure on now onto Smallberger. They can see that, unfortunately, the pressure that was put onto Jody Robertson, and a bit more than the pressure. That's a little nudge there from Rodriguez. Might just give them a chance of sneaking up a couple more positions.
Absolutely. And Valdi knows that. Valdi knows that he's got to go now, because Eddie's got the horns out. He's driving incredibly well. Gavin Ross into about sixth position. It's been a while since Gav has had so much fun. And Charles Smallberger running it very wide out of one. A really, really bad place to do that. There it is. But going for the lead.
Oh, a little rubbing there, but they've come together.
Adrian Wood, great job there, boy. Great job putting a whole bunch of pressure on Needham, foxing him in the mirror, forcing Needham wide. Going through turn one together. Here it is. Needham on the outside, Wood on the inside. And Wood has done it.
Again. In turn one again. Can you believe it? Same as he did in race number
one.
And up
the inside.
Comes back at him though. Needham has another look on the inside there. This is great racing between these two. I've got to say, hats off. Nothing better than these two going at it. And lots of respect. Basically the master, because Needham's been at this for a long, long time. And this is Woody's rookie season. So he really is showing what it takes, like this man has done at the front end since he moved to Class A.
Kelvin van der Linde out in front in Class A. Comfortably in Class A. Probably short-shifting that city golf of his. Doing a superb job, takes the flag, two wins on the first time out in Class A. Great job, boy.
Brilliant stuff. George Economides hanging on to second place and keeping Valdi out. Very important there. That's the championship battle for Class A, but Kelvin van der Linde moves into a very comfortable lead in the overalls. Adrian Wood and Needham, great battle for C.
A day of doubles here today, buddy. Awesome stuff. That's what it's all about, coming to a new class and showing them who's boss.
Yeah, great day before us today. Car was really beautiful. Loved every minute of it, and just thanks to everyone who helped out and making the car dream to drive.
Things are looking good now. I'm not quite sure if it's quite done and dusted yet, but it must be very close for the overall as well.
Yeah, look, we just try to keep consistent, bag the points, and we'll see what happens afterwards.
Absolutely no respect shown here by this youngster, hey?
No, he's absolutely stunning, this Oak. He's going to have a nice future. He gave me space, I gave him space. It was brilliant, brilliant, brilliant.
And the COC seemed happy with that, Adrian. But more importantly, he must be happy with the double victory.
Yeah, well, we finally managed to turn the end of the season around, getting everything right, managed to finish both races. Well done to Andre. We had a good clean race, good dice, not much touching. Hopefully we can carry that till the rest of the year.
Looking forward to that. Also looking forward to race two now of classes B and D. Atkinson, he's got to get off the line while he does that. But Andrea Bate has outdone him into turn one. So has Earcoat. It just seems to battle to get that pole off the line.
Goes from second to fourth again. Atkinson giving himself a huge amount of pressure and a huge amount of work. Earcoat up the inside. Up the inside of him goes, that's Van Sale, I think.
Yeah, Van Sal's making through there, and unfortunately, he looks like he's falling into the clutches of Cruiser. Cruiser had to start at the back and has come through quite nicely, already up into fifth place. As you see, Class D, another man coming from behind now. Darren Nathan getting the car sorted out, so you boys had a bit of work to do between the heats, but it's done and dusted, and it's now up to Darren to get to the front.
Out in front, though, we've got Jake Jacobs. Dion Holliday second, Voteros third, Monroe's fourth. What happened to Hurley? Hurley's down into fifth position. There's cars going everywhere at the moment. Hurley must have had a bad start. He must have missed a gear, and he's down in fifth position. Great job for Darren.
There's a move early on and sneaking through on Van Sale. So Van Sale getting false one. Onto the dirt as Elmer sneaks through as well. So changes up there, and Van Sale with a good start, but not able to maintain it.
Rory Atkinson up into second position though. Linda Hennon sitting in the background going, you guys make too many errors, I'm coming through. And having a look though, Andrea doing a great job. Echoed in second. Rory Atkinson with a little bit of work to do, unfortunately, because of his start. He's going to have to go as hard as he can to catch up to the front.
The pressure's on from behind from Elmer Cruiser. And no pressure at the front end too. Running wide into Execuline Corner. I think that was Monroe. We got it completely wrong there.
Voteros goes up the inside of Dean Jeffrey. Jeffrey in the first race ever, yeah, he goes around the outside. Oh, Van Vleter squeezed out. Dean staying on the throttle. Voteros gets the position though. Out in front though is still Jake Jacobs.
No, I think Dean's saying, don't worry, Voteros. I know where you live and I know where your car comes to be serviced. Onto the braking markers. Yes, Darren Nathan on the Batman. Looking through, there goes Dean returning the favour on Voteros. Love your work, bud. Keep it up. As Darren tries to go on the inside, he squeezes in. Oh, and a little touch there between them. Dean's in the way there. There's a possibility. He's going to go through the middle. Voteros closes the door. Oh, and a touch between the two of them. That's it. One of the second quickest parts of the track. That is awesome stuff.
Absolutely mind-blowing stuff. And up the inside comes Rory Atkins, and he takes second position away from Craig Eckhout. He's now got his sights set on Andrea, and he has to drive it as hard as he can. Craig has not let go. Whoa, Rory running it slightly wide. Is he backing with the rubber already? That's a little bit soon in this race to be battling with rubber, but he is really struggling with that motor car. Maybe he just made a mistake. Coming up the inside though is Elna. She made that error earlier. She backs out of it this time. Craig Eckhout still in third position.
Yeah, survives that one because remember Elna took out Van Vleter in the first race in that corner. She realized she wasn't on the right line. Much better driving there, and Eckhout surviving as I said. But he's also pulled a bit of a gap because she had to climb so hard on the anchors in Goldwagen corner. Here comes Class D. There's your first four. Fifth place is the Batman. Then Yanni Van Rooyen and Darren Nathan. There's a move from Voteros on Adrian Dalton sneaking through there. So there must have been some mayhem at the top because there's lots of guys involved there all of a sudden. And Pete Pottinger is one of them just in the background.
These cars are so evenly matched. So out in front we've got Jake Jacobs. Then we've got Dion Holliday in his brand new Polo. We've got Hurley in third position. Pete Pottinger is trying to get rid of Gina Monroe. She is right behind that car and has been all day. Goes up the inside. Pit slams the door. Gina probably thinking, what must I do to get past this guy?
Maybe just put a car between the two of them and let's see whether or not they can open up the door. Here we go. Move on the inside. Hurley sneaks up on Holliday. So Holliday changing up into second place now and moves up for an opportunity of catching Jacobs. I think Holliday will try and run with him. Then Monroe, here comes the move for fifth place, and it's up the inside there from Yanni Van Rooyen. It looks like he might have made a stick on Van Vleter. We'll have to wait and see as we see them come up onto the top of the hill.
Absolutely, yeah. That Darren Nathan also getting involved in that battle, but Hurley now knows what he has to do. He's got to go as hard as he possibly can. The championship is still at stake. Jake Jacobs out in front. Darren goes up the inside of Henry Van Vleter going into the top. He's now chasing Yanni Van Rooyen, and this racing all over. Elna Cruiser goes up the inside to have a look again at Echo. Craig Echo still ahead of her. Elna now up the inside. A drag race to turn four. Let's see who gets it first.
Side by side action onto the back straight. And looks like Elna's got the line. So Echo using the fastest part of the track and of that particular part of the track, I should say, as they come through and absolutely perfectly done. Cuts onto the inside, holds the inside line, but Echo comes back at her. So he's done the cutback. And can he go now side by side up towards Sassel Corner? It's going to take lots of late braking. Yanni Eckhout is very good on the brakes. Turning in. Oh, there's enough room given. That's brilliant. That's the kind of racing we like to see in Goldwagen.
That's insane respect between those two cars. Enough room. They touched mirrors. They didn't trade paint. And they're still doing it. This time, though, Elna gets ahead of him. Craig slots in behind, realizing that he's not finished yet. He's still having another look. Goes to the outside. Elna has to go defensive. Craig is trying as hard as he possibly knows how.
Well, Elna did a good job there. She went defensive down the straight between Ezekieline and Goldwagen and just blocked that line. We have got two corners to go, two laps and two corners, and all of a sudden Hurley is on the back end, and it looks like Jake Jacobs is in some problems. The Trent Properties machine. All over the back of him is the Kony Polo. And now they've caught onto the back end of Funsale, who's just trying to hang on. He's the back marker in Class B. He's been caught by the leaders. And it looks like he might just play a bit of a role here and help out Steve Hurley.
Hurley goes right around the outside of Funsale. He knew that he could not let Funsale get in between him and Jay Jacobs. He is doing a superb job. And Hurley knows this is it. Going down into turn two, he's going to try and set him up, go up the inside, force Jakes into a mistake. I think Jakes probably sitting there going, jeez, how long are these races? I've been out of this racing for such a long time. Jeez, running out of breath. There it is. Hurley goes up the inside. Jakes squeezes him but has to let him go. Otherwise, they would slam into each other. That's keeping in mind that is Ryan Tholo's car, not Jakes's.
Exactly. So a little bit of respect there from the two elder statesmen and leaders of Class D as they get onto the back straight. Watch out for Nathan, he's up to third place. There he is, but he's still under big pressure. As you see, Yannick van Rooyen all of a sudden has caught onto the back of him. And there's going to be a dice to the line. They've now got 1.5 laps to go as they head up to the hill and into Sasol Corner.
Can Jakes do it at the top? Or is he going to sit there and just try and force Hurley into an error? No, he stays on the line, tries to run Hurley into a mistake. Steve Hurley, though, doing a superb job. He's really on form here this weekend. That car doing a great job. The Hope Racing motor car doing exactly what it needs to do to capitalize on the points for the championship.
Yeah, he's going to open up a bit of a margin between himself and Nathan now as they go into the final round and onto the braking markers into Goldwagen Corner. This is what it's all about. The chicken flag is going to be waiting the next time they come through because they've got one more to go. Has Jake's got what it takes? No one's going to catch Andrea at the front. She's opened up a really nice margin and it should be just enough to keep out Rory Atkinson, who's moved to second place. Alma, unfortunately, has lost a bit of ground also to the second place man, Rory Atkinson.
I'm sure she's quite disappointed. She had the pace this weekend, but out in front, yeah, here's Andrea. She's going to also, for the first time ever, take two wins. If she can hang on for one more corner, take two wins in the Class B of the Goldwagen Challenge. The first time she has ever done it. A great job by Andrea Bate.
Yeah, brilliant driving there and a double victory for the lady. Superb stuff. And second place going to go to Rory Atkinson. Just in the background comes our second lady of the day, and that's Alma Cruiser taking third place in Class B. Down in Class D, though, it's not over. Here comes Jakes. He's going to throw everything he can at Steve Hurley, possibly spoil his double for the day. Or is he? They're coming down to Goldwagen Corner. Looks like Hurley's got just enough there. Yes, he has. He'll come through Goldwagen and take a double for the day for the Kony team and Hub Racing. Second place going to be Prent Properties and Nathan's Motorsport. Third place goes to the Sex Trader car of Darren Nathan. Good driving all the way through with Gunny van Rooyen on his tail for fourth. Confirmation of those results, you can see Bate, Atkinson and Cruiser, your top three. Hurley, Jacobs and Darren Nathan in third place ahead of Yannick van Rooyen and Adrian Dalton.
Fantastic day in the saddle for you today. Double victory and the overall as well. That's exactly what you wanted.
Yeah, clean sweep for today. I'm very excited. Thanks a lot to the guys that have helped me, encouraged me. It's taken a while to get to this point, but get a good start and mission off, eh? And then manage the gap. That's what you need to do.
After race one, it looked like it was all done and dusted. Then you went and threw it away and had to do a bit of work.
I just battled with this car off the start line. I can never get second gear, and it's cost me so many points this year. But anyway, from the contrast from the first heat where I was kind of nothing to do to everything to do, and flat out from the minute the flag went to the end. But it was awesome. Thanks to Jakes, he wasn't too difficult to pass. He didn't get in the way, no blocking. It was fantastic. What a fantastic day.
Calvin van der Linde with a comfortable margin heading into the final round. Andre Needham also looking good in Class C. Steve Hurley with some pressure, and George Economides hanging on to A. A big thanks to Goldwagen for all this action from SWATCOPS.